So, I receive a lot of emails, you know, and it always come back to this one question. So, Warren, my ex left me for some other bum-ass person, but they keep their things at my house, or they have certain little things they refuse to come back and pick up. What do that mean, Warren? First, I want to say this. Please like and subscribe to the channel. Now, with that being said, let's jump straight into it. The reason why they, you know, leave those things behind is because it's a attachment. It's an attachment. Just in case I need to, you know, keep in contact with you. You know, that's all that is. Because if you cut off all contact with that person, that's the end of the relationship. You know, I think I did a video stating this, like when they cut off all contact with you, you know, you can't get in contact with that person whatsoever, then that's really the end of the relationship. See, they keep those attachments like shoes, clothes, cars, you know, certain things that not so important. They can go a little, you know, a length of time without reaching back to get it, but it's still important enough for them to need it. So, they'll probably leave the, you know, Sunday suit, you know, big Sunday suit where they wear to church at your house or something like that. They might leave their social security card, a driver license, or things of that nature, knowing damn well they can get it, this stuff replaced. They want that attachment. So they can call you one day with that stupid ass phone call. They'd be like, hello? Hey, what's up? What you want? They'd be like, you know, I left my little child shoes over there when I was in third grade. You remember those shoes? And my sweater. You know, the Happy Elmo sweater. You know, the Sesame Street sweater. You remember that? I'ma need that. You know damn well they can't fit that sweater no more. You know damn well they don't even wear that sweater no more. But they use that as an excuse to get back in touch with you. So here's the thing, what you do. If they venture out the relationship and went to somebody else, you know, 9 times out of 10, they're going to be a bum, a downgrade, a low-hanging fruit. They choose some little painkiller to run their little ass to. What you do, you pack their stuff up. You know, if they have a friend, family member, you know, take it to them. Be careful what you do with this stuff, because by law, they can sue you if you damage their stuff. Most, you know, people I know, they had a yard sale and they got rid of the stuff. Or they find someone, you know, that could fit their, you know, the person's stuff, their ex, you know, stuff. So pack it up. You can put it in storage and let that person know that your stuff is in storage. It's up to you now to go get your stuff if you really, really want it. Take it to a friend or family member house or stuff like that. Have a friend or family member come over to your house, apartment, or wherever y'all stay in, that trailer, you know, bungalow, whatever y'all in, to come pick up their stuff and take it back with them. 9 times out of 10, they a bum and they ain't got no place to stay. And they just using your house for storage because they don't have nobody to come pick up their stuff and they don't have no place to put their stuff. So they leave their stuff at your house because they don't have a place to put it. That's a, you know, alibi too. But the best thing to do is to get someone to come get their stuff. The more of this video, why they leave that stuff at your house and they don't come get it, because it's a attachment. It's an attachment. They use that to get back, keep their foot in the door with you. So you need to cut all ties. If they went out the relationship and went God knows where, with God knows who, look at that. Look at their actions. Is that an indication of a person that really loves you? If they go stick their you know, penis, or they have, you know, let somebody stick a penis in them, you know, that person is not for you. Especially, you know, they're creating soul ties and, you know, diseases and epidemics or infections and all that stuff going around nowadays. You got to be very careful with your body. Your body is a temple. Don't you know that? Your body is a temple. You don't let no nasty ass person come in your temple, no matter who it is. So with that being said, get that stuff out your house. That's an attachment. Cut all attachment. The root of all suffering is attachment and desire. Attachment and desire. Cut those attachments. Let that person go free. That's what he want. Give it to him. Don't matter who it is. Friends, family members, jobs, all that stuff. Cut all attachments. Now, with that being said, if you'd like to get in contact with me, you send me an email. Or if you don't want to send me an email, you can send me a text message. And I'm here. Just text me what's going on. I'll text you the steps. Then we, you know, we go from there. Now, with that being said, watch out for one another. Pray for one another. Be safe. Take care of yourself.
This song's dedicated to my homies in that gangster lane. Why do you have to go so soon? It seems like yesterday we were hanging round the hood. Now I'm gonna keep your memory alive. A homie should. A lifetime of memory going down the drain. I like to keep stepping, but I can't get past the pain.
I kept my body to your memory. Take a drink and I start to think. And I know one day soon we'll be hanging out.
This is for my homies.
This is for my homies. Well, well.
See you when I get there
in that gangsta lane. That gangsta lane.
This is for my homies.
This is for my homies, where?
See you when I get there.
In that gangsta lane, that gangsta lane.
My God, could you pass on a message from me? Tell him put down those dice for a second, Lord. Listen to his homie. Could you tell him I'll never let go of his memory, so his son will know? You don't have to cry no more, 'cause God's got his back. I said God's got his back.
A lifetime of memories,
lifetime of memories,
going down the drain,
going down the drain.
I'd like to keep stepping.
dedicated to my homies in that gangster league. Tommy from Master's Touch, my boy YB, and my boy Emir. And whoever else out there got a homie that's in that gangster league. And also my boys in the pen, and they'll never see the street again. Cause you know what? It don't matter what they was doing while they was here. They could've been banging, slanging, but they ain't here no more. Now somebody's daddy, somebody's baby, that's somebody's homie. So go and let them rest in peace while they in that gangster lean. You know what I'm saying? That's on the real low.
This is for my homie.
I'm sorry you're gone, but I've got to keep on.
This
I
is gotta-